Swadika, hello everyone. I'm tired of in the United States. Today, I would like to talk about some little thing that I see the differences between here and Thailand. First thing, mailbox in front of the house. When I live in Thailand, mailbox over there normally gonna be the small box hang on the fence, or some houses they build a house and attach the box next to the gate, or not next to the gate, attached at the gate. And some houses they just make the box that stand in front of the gate, depends on the design of the houses. But in the United States, every house is gonna have the mailbox at the curve in front of the house. And some houses that have really long way, the driveway to the house, they might put the mailbox in front of the street at the house, and then they need to travel a little bit to get the mail, some kind like that. And also some places like apartment, they provided the area to store mailboxes, which is unit of the apartment can check the mail by themselves. And another one is the mailbox at the post office. In Thailand, I heard people using mailbox at the post office normally, or are companies and businesses, but not residential. But here, people live in residence, like general regular people, using both the home address and mailbox. But in Thailand, I only have home address, never have mailbox. Also, I look on YouTube about hotel. Some hotel and condominium, they will provide the box. I learned something, the new word, but I don't remember exactly what word is that. If I was wrong, if I said wrong, I will search the word and put in the bottom for you, okay? Is that called octopus hole? Octopus hole maybe, the odd dog hole or something, like to contain the mail for the guests who stay in apartment or hotel room. But in Thailand, normally I see people live in apartment, they can get from the counter, the reception, or some apartment like the one I stay, they gonna insert under the door for us when I have mail, or they gonna leave the note that I have package to pick up at the staff at the counter or some kind like that. And then one thing that I was doubting for a while before I asked my husband is the red flag at the mailbox in front of the house. I have no idea what that for. And then I asked my husband. He told me when we have mail to pick up, because the mailman gonna come and deliver the mail to us, a letter to us, and if we have mail or packages would like to send, then we can put in the box, or sometime too big, I just make the note and then leave the box by the front door or in the house, depends on if I am at home or not. And then I leave the note like, please pick up the packages inside the house, some kind of that. So the red flag will lift up when we have letters and packages to delivery, to send, not delivery, to send, and then the mailman gonna pick up and then let the flag down again. This make me think about the movie the lake house, the lake house, because one scene they, the guy and the woman, Keanu Reeves and Sandra Bullock, communicate to each other in different period of time, and while they're standing at the mailbox, the flag up and then down without people touch it because they live in different period of the time. If you never seen it, go check. Okay, and the courier service in Thailand, what I know, we have DHL, I don't see in America, and we have FedEx, I see here, very regularly, usual, courier, and then other one is UPS and Post. This is what I know, and we can drop packages in the office where they provided around us, but in Thailand I have never seen that we can drop, because normally we will use I mean what I know, because my personal, if I send something domestic in country, I will never use the FedEx or DHL or UPS. I just use the post. But when I would like to ship things overseas, I will use them because they are faster than the post, but they're expensive, more expensive. But in the USA, we can use their service, Post, FedEx, or UPS, either way, domestic or international. And when I pack the package here, I can pack, just use any boxes and then tape it and then stamp, it's fine. And also the envelope and packages, not packages, and the box flat rate, that is useful for me when I ship something heavy and the cost by itself gonna be more expensive than using the flat rate envelope or flat rate box, because the cost gonna be safer, cheaper, and save my money. In Thailand, every time when we do package, we need to send to somebody, we cannot just use any box. We need to use the box that we purchased from post office, or we need to use any box and then wrap with the plain white paper that I used to, or brown paper, and need to have string to tie it on the box before sending to. But in the United States, in here, I really like the system. I can wrap the box, even wrap the gift paper, the present paper, gift wrap. But in Thailand, you can't. You need to, if you would like to use gift wrap paper, you can do it, and then you need to cover with the brown or white paper before you send it. I live in Bangkok, Thailand. One service that we use it when we would like to delivery document or packages urgently in one day, we will hiring messenger, that's a person normally using motorcycle, because in Bangkok is very bad traffic, and messenger motorcycle is the fastest way, and compared with the courier UPS or DHL or FedEx, that much more cheaper, because the messenger motorcycle will charge only for their service, not charge for the packet heavy or the size of the package, not like that. Anyway, I don't know about in other province because I never lived in any provinces for long time as a worker person. I always live in Bangkok and this is what we use to delivery some things in one day urgently. That's it all I would like to talk about today. So if you have experience like me in different country from where you come from and something like this different, I will check on you. That interesting to know, right? And I will talk about something else next time. I think I have the idea what I'm gonna tell you, but I need to wait until I'm ready to talk about it because of English barrier. I need to think about the word first. Thank you for watching and I hope everybody enjoy nice with summer now. Thank you everyone who's stopping by and listening to me until the end. Have a good one. Bye. สวัสดีค่ะ